Here we are given that y is to z is equal to 3 is to 7. So we can write it down as y equal to 3a and z equal to 7a. So we can know that angle x is equal to angle z y just because they are alternate angle. Angle x is equal to angle z is equal to alternate angle, and angle y plus angle x is equal to 180 degree. Co-interior angle, sum of co-interior angle is equal to 180 degree. Co-interior angle, so we can write it down as angle y plus angle z equal to 180 degree. And we know that y is equal to 3a and angle z equal to 7a. So we can write it down as 3a plus 7a is equal to 180 degree. So tan a is equal to 180. So a is equal to 18 degree. And a is equal to 18 degree. So x is equal to 7a and 7a is equal to 7 into 18, which is 126 degree, and which is our required answer. In figure, AB is parallel to CD and EF is perpendicular to CD. Angle GED is equal to 126 degree. Find angle AGE, GEF and FGE. So we know that angle GED is equal to angle GEF plus angle FED. Angle GED is equal to angle GEF plus FED. So we can write it down as angle GED is equal to 126 degree, angle GEF plus angle FED is equal to 90 degree. So angle GEF is equal to 36 degree. And we know that FGE plus angle GEF plus angle FEG is equal to 180 degree. Because sum of all the angle in a triangle is 180 degree. So angle FGE plus 90 degree plus 36 degree is equal to 180 degree. So angle FGE is equal to 54 degree. And similarly we can write it down as angle AG is equal to 180 minus 54, which is nothing but 126 degree. In question 13, triangle ABC is an isosceles triangle in which angle B is equal to C and LM and are met point on AB and AC respectively such that LM is parallel to BC. So first of all, we make a triangle ABC an isosceles triangle. Name the triangle as A B C. LM and R are point on AB and AC respectively. Name them as LM. LM is parallel to BC. Name the angle as angle 1, angle 2, this is angle 3, angle 4. We know that in isosceles triangle angle 3 is equal to angle 4. Okay, angle 3 is equal to angle 4. And we know that the sum of all the angle in a triangle is 180 degree. So angle 3 plus angle 4 plus angle A is equal to 180 degree. And here from twice of angle 3 equal to 180 minus 50, which is equal to 130 degree. So angle 3 is equal to 65 degree, or and we know that angle 3 is equal to angle 4, so angle 3 equal to angle 4 equal to 65 degree, and we know that angle 4 is equal to angle 2, which is equal to 65 degree, just because they are corresponding angle. And angle 2 plus angle LMC is equal to 180 degree. Angle in a straight line is equal to 180 degree. So from here we can write it down as angle LMC is equal to 180 minus 65, which is equal to 115 degree. AB is parallel to DF, so AB is parallel to DE also, and FG is parallel to AD is parallel to FG, so FG is parallel to CD also. Angle BAC is 65, angle ACB is equal to 55 degree, and we have to find out angle FGH. Okay, so from here we can write it down as angle BAC is equal to angle EDC, which is equal to 65 degree. The reason is alternate angle. And similarly, angle BCA is equal to angle ECD is equal to 55 degree. The reason is vertically opposite angle. This is the symbol of angle. Similarly, we can write it down as angle EDC is equal to angle EFG, which is equal to 65 degree. Again, alternate angle. And we know that angle ECD plus angle CDE plus angle DEC is equal to 180 degree. Here it is equal to 55 degree plus 65 degree plus angle DEC is equal to 180 degree. So angle DEC is equal to 60 degree, and which is equal to angle FEG, again alternate angle. And similarly, we can know that FEG plus angle EFG is equal to angle FGH. The reason is exterior angle of a triangle is equal to the sum of the interior opposite angle. So from here we can write it down as angle FGH is equal to 60 degree plus 65 degree, which is equal to 125 degree, which is our required answer. In figure, AB is parallel to ED, angle ABC 30 degree, ED is equal to 70 degree, then find X. In this question we have to do a small construction, like just draw a diagram again. Angle B, angle A, E, D, 7D, angle 30, just draw a line parallel to AB and ED from the point C. Okay, now here we know that angle ABC plus angle, name this line as BCG, angle ABC plus angle BCG is equal to 180 degree. The reason is co-interior angle. So angle ABC, we know that angle ABC is 30 degree. Angle BCG is equal to 180 degree. So angle BCG is equal to 150 degree. Similarly, we can write it down as EDF plus angle GCD is equal to 180 degree. It is 70 degree plus angle GCD 180 degree. So angle GCD is equal to 1110, and we know that angle X is nothing but it is the sum of angle BCG plus angle GCD, and BCG is 1110 plus 150 degree. So X is equal to 260 degree. Answer. In figure, POQ is a line, ray OR is perpendicular to line PQQS is another ray lying between ray OP and OR. Prove that angle ROS is equal to half of angle QS minus POS. So we know that angle POS plus angle QOS is equal to 180 degree. Sorry. But angle QOS is nothing but angle ROS plus angle QOR, and angle QOR is equal to angle POR equal to 90 degree, which is equal to angle POS plus angle ROS. So angle POS plus angle QOS is equal to angle POS plus ROS plus angle POS plus ROS. So from here we can write it down as angle POS plus QOS is equal to twice of angle POS plus ROS. So twice of ROS is equal to angle QOS minus POS. So angle ROS is equal to half of QOS minus angle POS, which is our required result. PS is the bisector of angle QPR and PT is perpendicular. To prove that, show that angle TPS is equal to half of angle Q minus half of angle R. So PS is the bisector of angle QPR, so we can write it down as angle QPS is equal to angle SPR, because PS is the bisector of angle QPR. So in triangle PQT we have angle PQT plus angle PDQ plus angle QPT is equal to 180 degree. Angle PQT plus angle PTQ is nothing but 90 degree plus angle QPT. Equal to 180 degree. So from here we can write it down as angle PQD is equal to 90 degree minus angle QPD, and PQT is nothing but angle Q is equal to 90 minus angle QPD. Similarly in triangle PTR, similarly in triangle PTR we have एंगल, सॉरी एंगल पी आर टी इक्वल टू 180 डिग्री एंड एंगल पी आर टी प्लस टी पी आर प्लस 90 इक्वल टू 180. सो एंगल पी आर टी इज इक्वल टू 90 माइनस एंगल टी पी आर एंड एंगल पी आर टी इज नथिंग बट एंगल आर विच इज इक्वल टू 90 माइनस टी पी आर. नेम द इक्वेशन एज एंड टू सब्ट्रैक्ट इक्वेशन सेकेंड फ्रॉम फर्स्ट वी गेट ट्वाइस माइनस वन वी गेट सॉरी एंगल क्यू माइनस एंगल आर इज इक्वल टू सो बाय कैंसलिंग 90 ऑन बोथ साइड वी गेट एंगल टी पी आर माइनस एंगल क्यू पी टी एंड टी पी आर इज नथिंग बट एंगल टी पी एस प्लस एस पी आर माइनस क्यू पी टी इज इक्वल टू एंगल क्यू पी एस माइनस टी पी एस. सो एंगल क्यू माइनस एंगल आर इज इक्वल टू ट्वाइस ऑफ एंगल टी पी एस आर विच इज अवर रिक्वायर्ड रिजल्ट इफ टू पैरेलल लाइन आर इंटरसेक्टेड बाय अ ट्रांसवर्सल. सो जस्ट मेक अ टू पैरेलल लाइन name the transversal as F intersected prove that the bisectors of the interior angle on the same side of transversal intersect each other at right angle. So here make the bisector of this and again make the bisector of this. Name the angle as angle 1 angle 2 angle 3 and the intersection point is P. Here this point is M and this point is N. We know that the sum of the interior angle on the same side of the transversal is 180 degree. So we can write it down as angle BMN plus angle DNM equal to 180 degree and half of angle BMN plus half of angle DNM is equal to 90 degree. We divide the equation by 2. So half of angle BMN is nothing but angle PMN plus half of angle DNM is nothing but angle PNM which is equal to 90 degree and angle PMN is nothing but angle 1 plus angle 2 equal to 90 degree and we know that the sum of our sum of all the angle in a triangle is 180 degrees. So in triangle PMN we have angle 1 plus angle 2 plus angle 3 equal to 180 degree and we know that angle 1 plus 2 is equal to 90 plus angle 3 equal to 180 degree. So angle 3 is equal to 90 degree and PM and PN intersect at right angles. So hence proved. Question 19. Find the value of x and y. We have to find out the value of angle x and angle y. So we know that PQ is parallel to SR and QR is the transversal. So we can write it down as angle PQR is equal to angle TRQ. The reason is The reason is alternate angle, and angle PQR is equal to angle X plus 28 is equal to 65 degree. So angle X is equal to 37 degree. Now in triangle PQS we have angle QPS plus angle PQS plus angle PSQ is equal to 180 degree. It is angle 90 plus angle 37 plus angle Y equal to 180 degree. So from here we get Y equal to 180 minus 127, which is equal to 53 degree. In this question we have to find out the value of X, Y and Z. So here AB is parallel to CD and CD is parallel to EF, so we can say that AB is parallel to CD is parallel to EF, and EA is perpendicular to AB, and EA on angle BF equal to 55 degree. So angle X is equal to angle Y just because they are corresponding angle. And we know that the interior angle on the same side of the transversal are supplementary. So angle Y plus 55 equal to 180 degree. So angle Y is equal to 125 degree, which is equal to angle X. Since AB is parallel to CD and CD is parallel to EF, so AB is parallel to EF. AB is parallel to EF, so we can write it down as angle EAB plus angle FEA equal to 180 degree. Reason is interior angle on the same side of the transversal EA are supplementary. So angle 90 plus Z plus 55 is equal to 180 degree. So angle Z is equal to 35 degree. So we can find angle X, Y and Z. Here it is our answer. Thank you.